welcome to Talk to Tiger. Today we have my good friend Rupa. We have been classmates in college and we went off to different paths. While I chose something else, Rupa continued her work in IT, and she has been practicing heartfulness and meditation for the last decade and a half. So every time someone in a group gets stressed or there's an opportunity, she tries to push this meditation techniques to us. So I thought we'll explore more about it, and we had a couple of discussions about heartfulness. So I requested Rupa to join us and tell us about what is heartfulness, how it can help us improve our mental stress, how to improve our efficiency and make us calm. So Rupa, welcome to Dr. Tiger. It's a pleasure to have you.
Yeah, hi Vamshi. Thank you for asking me to talk about this. So today I'm going to talk about heartfulness meditation.
Yes.
So it's all about trying to listen to the guidance that heart produces, and also it is about getting the courage to follow the guidance of the heart. It's about making the right choices.
So why did you start trying to understand meditation and all that, but why did you start this?
So it was always from my childhood. Brought up in a communist family, my grandfather was always telling me about the courage and equality. He's talking about courage and equality. And it was there always inside my mind. But exploring this heartfulness meditation, there was a book called My Master. I used to be a voracious reader at that time. So when I read this book, it seemed to be giving the answers to the questions that I had at that age. I was somewhere 20 years of age at that time. So it seemed to be giving very right answers to me at that time. So that's how I started this meditation, but I learned that it is much more deeper than what I thought in the beginning. So chose to continue it.
Yeah. So when you first got introduced, so was there a problem, or were you trying to improve something? How did you start off?
So what I observed basically was, we all wanted to say the truth. We all wanted to accept people. But when it comes to real-time situations, right, most of the times, it's not that we don't know, but we lack the courage, right, to follow what we wanted to do. So it is in order to get the courage. So it's not that I had any problem. Actually, at that moment of the time, all my problems were done. Okay. I got settled actually by that time I joined this mission. So it's not that I had a problem actually, but it's a good thing that I understood. So hope I get a clear answer.
Yeah. So what is heartfulness? Can you explain the concept?
Okay. So as I said, a human being has various faculties. Like we have mind, we have intellect, we have heart, right? And each one, everything has its own function, right? Yeah. Like how to do, our mind will say, they say. And intellect has discrimination ability and decision making ability, they say. And heart is the one which tells us what to do. Okay, it has got this immense intelligence. Now science is finding out that our heart has more neurons than our brain. The HeartMath Institute is actually exploring this. They're doing this research, and there are many books called Heart's Code. And now also heart also has, we measure EEG. That means the vibrations that come out of heart, the way the heart communicates. You know, we are making leaps and bounds forward in this field now. But our ancient wisdom has already explored this. You know, it's a simple thing, right? Like when we say lie when we were children, right? Within half an hour or so, we used to go back to mommy and say that I just simply said it. That was a lie. That was not true. Right? So there is something, always this guidance that heart is giving us. Right? And the only thing is, we don't have the courage to follow it as we grow because of the social conditioning. Right, and because of thinking what the others might feel, right? So we somehow stop listening to it. We also call it conscience, right? when we start stop listening to it, what will happen? Its voice becomes feeble, and our mind starts dominating. Mind starts giving reasons. So why it has become so difficult is, heart says do this, but it doesn't give the reason. But as we grow, we become more accustomed to reason, right? The mind will say, I am telling lie because I have to safeguard myself, like this, right? But heart will say, this is the truth. So, right?
So how do we connect to the heart? So are there some exercises which people can follow?
Yes. So heartfulness meditation actually provides us some techniques. Okay. So there are nearly 3 to 4 techniques involved in this. So first thing is relaxation that makes our physical body relax. Okay. We can do this anytime. So then the second thing is this heartfulness meditation, where we try to focus or rest our mind on the heart. We try to hear what is coming from within. So here the trick is, right, I just wanted to tell this, like all our physical body, they don't tell us when they are working fine, right? Our nose, only when we get cold that we will feel disturbance in our nose, right? Mm-hmm. Similarly, when we are doing right things, heart won't say anything. It won't say sabhash, right? But when we go wrong, it tries to give us the guidance. There is a pinch, there is a pull. So this meditation helps us to listen to that voice, because we have that voice has become so feeble now. We are trying to listen. We are trying to pause and listen to what's coming from within. That's the meditation. The third technique is most important technique, and which I really like, is called rejuvenation or cleaning. This is about removing our baggage. Mm-hmm. Consciously or unconsciously carry a lot of emotional baggage, right? Just like in the afternoon, I went out to buy the vegetables just in front of my apartment, and subconsciously my mind is very alert. Previously we were not so alert, right? It is very alert, like who is coming near me and how far each person is. So subconsciously, your amygdala and everything has started. They already hold your guns trying to. It is in a defensive mode, right? So when we are in such a mode, generally we will not be able to hear what is coming from the heart, right? So these emotional baggages which we carry and bring home, there's a method called rejuvenation that really helps us remove this baggage, everyday baggage. So I just came home and then just sat for 10 minutes, did my cleaning, then I will be clean. So that technique is very useful, which I find it very useful in my office life. Every day we talk, and our children will identify it first. As soon as we come inside, they will understand whether my father is coming happily or is he coming in a different mood, right? So we carry that vibration and they catch it very fast. And here is a method that we just go inside our house, just wash our hands and legs and sit for 10 minutes and remove that baggage. It's a very effective system.
Okay. Third technique?
This third technique is cleaning. First I said relaxation, second is meditation, third is cleaning. And then we also have the fourth one, which is called as connecting to our inner self. So when we are sleeping also, subconsciously, how do we sleep? Remember when we were children, we just used to hit the bed and that's it. Gone. But as we grow, right, we are now not able to sleep. So there is a method of how to go to sleep nicely. So that is one of the fourth method.
So how long does it take for someone to understand and able to see the results?
Yeah, it's just like there is three days we usually give initial sessions. Mm-hmm. So we introduce one technique each day so that we are not overwhelmed with everything, right? Mm-hmm. So they just take 3 consecutive days. Introduce the system and then they can do it. So, but at least doing it for 3 months, start with the results.
So have you seen any, you are also a trainer, so have you seen any extreme cases that actually saw the result?
Yes, actually there will be many reasons, but there are obviously, as you said, there are some emotional cases which they were able to cope up and get stable.
Mm-hmm.
But what I would say is just not when you are in problem, right? Mm-hmm. When you are all right, this is more good, you know, you become healthy, right? So just by giving examples, I do not want to promise something, right? I just want each and every one of us to experiment within ourselves and find out.
So this particular form of meditation, how is it different from others? For example, there is yoga, some people have food therapy. So there are several ways of meditation. How is heartfulness different?
Yes.
Is this a completely different method, or is it bringing all those elements and trying to put it inside?
No. It's heartfulness meditation, right? Like any meditation, they say, is the focus on one single point. But heartfulness meditation takes help of something we call transmission.
Mm-hmm.
So this transmission is channelizing energy into yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So that we meditate. See, many people know about meditation, but they say, I can't sit for so long, so let me not try it, right? So, but here we make use of something called transmission. And this makes us sit, go into meditation very easily. So in the first or second session itself, you will be able to go with it depths. So that is one feature. And then, as I said, this cleaning, removing of baggage is one thing which is very unique to the system.
So sometimes carrying a lot of baggage, carrying a lot of stress at work, like you said, gets transformed into your driving, transformed into decision making.
Yes.
Also on family, it also help, affects on people's mental health.
Correct.
So you're saying spending some time with heartfulness method actually helps people.
Yes.
Detox probably in a
yes. Yes, you have used the right word. It is detoxes, not our emotional it also, like, you know, you will also become more self-awareness will be there. So see, in the beginning, maybe you will understand after the, see, a simple example I'll give, like when people will say that if you get angry, count 10. But you know, when we are angry, we don't even know that we are angry, right? After, it is that after effect, we realized that we were anger and we had to count 10. So that means our amygdala takes over our thinking capacity, right? So it is like we have to automate our system. Otherwise, you know, currently our system is hardwired with the brain, the defensive mechanism. But we have to rewire it to meditative state, to a state of pause. So that we can think rightly. So that is why this is the practice that helps in automation. And so we will become more self-aware. We know that we are getting angry, or we know that the control is getting better. And we try to distance ourselves emotionally from that. And also, if there is any impact, anyway, as I said, there is a cleaning technique when we come back. And as I said, there is a, before going to bed, these are the things that come to our mind. Why we won't sleep is any fights that we do or anything that won't let us go. That means our system is telling you cannot sleep with these things in your head. Please do something with that, right? So there is a technique here where we introspect and try to come to terms with that ourselves when we sleep. So these techniques. Are not complementary. They complement each other, but they are not complementary. It's a 24/7.
Yeah. So is there a minimum age I have a lot of audience who are between 18 and 25 years old.
Yeah.
People are going through stress with education, backlogs,
yes. Sudden
schools are stopped, a lot of stress on parents, job market is going down. So how will them practicing heartfulness help?
Yes. So this system is for children who are above 15 years of age. So because otherwise, so that they know what they are doing. Right? So 15 years is the age. anybody above 15 years.
So
they can go to the website. There is heartfulness.org website. And there is an Hearts app available. We'll give links. Android and in iOS also. Also, there is a website called Heartspots. So you can give your location and it will show all the trainers who are nearby. So trainers are the people, right? Like we sometimes want motivation to do along with somebody. So I welcome everybody to join this. And this is, they all work voluntarily. The whole system, there is no charge. It's free of charge.
So there's no fees at all for maintaining?
No fees for things. Except for the books that are published. The practice is entirely free. And in YouTube, you can see the videos. So it's all open.
So if you are, if you have emotionally tired, if you are taking decisions which are not happy about, if you are especially overwhelmed by what is happening around you and want to connect with your inner self, heartfulness is one way to do. And there are many trainers around who can help you without any charge. This is a safe place because the details are mentioned in the website. Verified trainers, right?
Yes.
So Rupa is also a trainer from heartfulness.org. You can always connect with her. What we try to speak in a 20-minute time span is very less. Yes. Most of the information is available on the website. We also have a small article published. I will share that link also. So if you want to reach out to Rupa, please get in touch with her. I'll share her email ID.
Yes.
Whether it is heartfulness or any other meditation, we believe as long as you connect with your soul and you're taking the right decision and you're taking care of yourself, that is the most important thing that you can do for yourself.
Correct. And just one point. This is available all over the world, like across 172 countries. So, and 24/7 trainers are available. So please make use of it. As I said, not just when you are in stress or strain, but to make yourself more healthy.
So this is just like a disease. When you're saying when you're not emotionally trained, so what usually happens is, it's just like a water bottle, glass of water. We keep filling it. We don't know it is full. And yes, then a bursting point.
Yes, suddenly.
You take care before, then it helps. So even if you're stressed out with whatever you are having in life, there are people who can listen to you, take help, ask for help, and you'll get it from heartfulness.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, Rupa, for joining with us and sharing this thought. I'm sure people will get in touch with you and then you can help.
Thank you, Amshi.